Explosives. An explosive is a substance or a mixture which, under the influence of thermal or mechanical shock, decomposes rapidly and spontaneously, resulting in the production of enormous amount of heat, large volume of gases, and consequent generation of sudden pressure on the surroundings.
Effect. The explosive reaction is exothermic. The products attain high heat and pressure. It has been estimated that during an explosion, a temperature of 5000 degrees Celsius and 230,000 kilogram per centimeter square pressure is produced. At this temperature, the volume of the evolved gases is about 1500 to 2000 tons as that of the explosive itself. Advantages and disadvantages. Explosives can be used for construction purposes like the creation of dams, tunnels, roads in hills, mining of old metals, etc. They are often used for the destruction purposes like in ammunition such as aerial bombs, rockets, torpedoes, grenades, etc. Classifications of explosives. Based on explosive strength and sensitivity, chemical explosives can be classified into three types: primary explosives, low explosives, high explosives. Primary explosives. They initiate the main explosion. These initiators are generally inorganic salts like lead, azide.
Low explosives. Low explosives are propellants, burn with a comparatively low reaction and will not explode suddenly. For example, colloidal cellulose nitrate, which is commercially known as smokeless powder, is a low explosive. Black powder, which is a combination of 75% KNO3, 15% charcoal and 10% sulfur, is also a low explosive. High explosives. High explosives with the help of detonators blast with a high energy and high exploding rate. High explosives are generally not very sensitive to mechanical shock and hence require a detonator. The high explosives can be classified as follows: single command explosives, binary explosives, plastic explosives, and dynamics. Single command explosives. Some of the efficient explosives are 2,4,6 trinitrochlorine, pentaerythritol tetranitrate, and cyclonitrate. TNT is safe to handle and has insufficient oxygen for a complete combustion. It is generally used in combined state with another explosive with a high positive oxygen valence. TNT is prepared by the nitration of toluene. PETN is prepared by the nitration of pentaerythritol. It is a highly sensitive explosive and transported wet with water. PETN mixed with TNT or plasticide nitrocellulose can be used as a highly explosive. RDX is prepared by the nitration of hexamine. Tetryl is a highly explosive prepared by the nitration of dimethyl aniline. Binary explosives. The example given below are some of the combination of powerful binary explosives and propellants.
Plastic explosives. Explosives which are in plastic state and can be hand molded are known as plastic explosives. PETN, which is highly sensitive and powerful explosive, can be mixed with wax or oil and hand molded can be handled safely. Dynamics. Dynamics or explosives are containing trinitroglycerin as the main ingredient. Trinitroglycerin is an oily liquid that suddenly explodes about 500 degrees Celsius or pressure or shock. It finds great use in blasting rocks, mining, demolition works, etc. For transporting purposes, trinitroglycerin is mixed with sawdust, starch meals, or wood pulp. Straight dynamite. It mainly contains trinitroglycerin along with small amount of ammonium nitrate and pulp or sawdust. It is mainly used in blasting hard rocks, mining, etc. Gelatin. It contains 91.5% trinitroglycerin, 8% gun cotton or trinitrocellulose. It is waterproof and hence used in submarine blasting and deep well sorting. Requisites of a good propellant. Combustion should be uniform, slow and steady. It should possess low ignition delay, high specific impulse and produce low molecular weight fuels, gases like carbon dioxide and nitrogen, etc. High density. It should be readily ignishable at predictable burning rate. It should not be toxic or corrosive. Stable over wide ranges of temperature. It should produce a large volume of gases and high temperature. Classifications of propellants. Propellants are classified into solid, liquid and hybrid. Solid propellants are classified into black powder or gunpowder, homogeneous, heterogeneous, composite or double base. Liquid propellants are classified into monopropellant and bipropellant. Liquid propellants. A. Monopropellants. A monopropellant has fuel as well as oxidizer in the same molecule or in a solution containing both these. The oxidants used are hydrogen peroxide nitromethane and the fuels used are methanol. B. Biliquid rocket propellants. These are more widely used propellants in this type. Fuel and oxidant are kept in a separate container and are injected in the combustion chamber separately. Commonly used fuels are liquid hydrogen, hydrazine, ethyl alcohol, aniline, and kerosene oil. It consists of oxidants like liquid oxygen, liquid ozone, hydrogen peroxide, fuming nitric acid. The liquid propellants have a higher specific impulse and combustion can be controlled. Solid propellants. A. Homogeneous solid rocket propellant. When solid propellant and oxidant is thoroughly mixed in colloidal state, it is called homogeneous solid propellant. The oxidants used are ammonium perchlorate or potassium nitrate. When single propellant is employed, it is called single base propellant. A solid propellant which contains two materials is called double base propellant. B. Heterogeneous solid rocket propellant. The oxidants and fuels used are in two distinct phases. The oxidants used are ammonium perchlorate or KNO3. The fuels used are hydrocarbon, synthesis, rubber, etc. The oxidizer should be stable, non-hydroscopic with contact with fuel and does not form any corrosive products. They are safe to handle and can be stored in combustion chamber. These are the differences between solid propellant and liquid propellant. Thank you.